Welcome to this module on assessment of dementia and caregiving in Chinese Americans. I am Marian Zhuang, and in this module, I'm going to be joined with Benjamin Gao, who is a licensed clinical social worker, who will be talking about Chinese cultural values and their perceptions of dementia. And then I will give an overview of a number of very commonly used Chinese cognitive assessment tools, and then followed by E.D. Yao, who's the Director of Diversity at the Alzheimer's Association, Northern California and Northern Nevada chapter. She will be talking about how with the best practices with working with Chinese dementia patients, their caregivers, and their family members.
The learning objectives for the Chinese American module include, first, identify the effects of cultural values on the views of dementia in Chinese American families. Second, select culturally and linguistically appropriate assessment tools for dementia with Chinese American patients. And lastly, integrate culturally appropriate strategies to work effectively with Chinese American families in caring for patients with dementia.
So in this module, I'm going to be talking about just giving a brief history of the Chinese in the United States, and then an overview of what we currently know about the dementia prevalence rate with the Chinese American elders, and as well as a number of risk factors. So Chinese immigration to the US came in three major waves. The first wave happened around mid-19th century. The Chinese, they came primarily to work as laborers in mines and on railroads. And as the number of Chinese laborers increased, so did the voice of anti-Chinese sentiment among other workers. So this eventually led to a number of anti-immigration laws that denied citizenship and naturalization and prevented Chinese from marrying Caucasians or even owning land. And it wasn't until the 1940s, when U.S. and China became allies during World War II, that the situation for Chinese Americans finally began to improve. Larger scale immigration occurred after natural origin quotas were lifted in 1965. And the third wave is right around the 1980s until the present day. Students and professionals from Taiwan, Hong Kong, and China came to the U.S. in large numbers. And according to the 2010 U.S. Census survey, the U.S. In the U.S., there's about 1% of the Chinese currently in the States. And the influx continues for each of the past years. Ethnic Chinese people coming from China, Taiwan, and to a lesser extent from other Southeast Asian countries are moving to the U.S., surpassing Hispanic and Latino immigrants in 2012. So let's take a closer look at data on Chinese elders in the U.S. So this pie chart gives the number of all Asian elders 65 and older in the U.S. according to the 2010 U.S. Census survey. So you can see that Chinese American elders are the largest subgroup of all Asian American elders at 27%, which is about 3.8 million people, and followed by Filipino elders at 21%, then Japanese and Asian Indians at around 13% each. Then there are a number of other smaller Southeast Asian populations. And most older Chinese Americans come from China, Taiwan, and Hong Kong, these three countries. And in recent decades, many are bicultural professionals or quote-unquote followers of children who immigrated after the 70s. And approximately 66% of all of them live in five states: California, New York, Hawaii, Illinois, and Texas. And if we take a closer look at the demographics, it will show that 70% of them are foreign-born. And close to 19% of them currently lives in poverty, and 31% has some form of disability, and 15% lives alone, and 60% of them speak little or no English, and 30% of them have less than 9 years of formal education. So this table shows data from a number of dementia prevalence studies that are conducted in Asian countries. It is a review article that has been published in 2012. So you'll notice that these are all data from Asian countries, and you'll be aware that there are actually no known reports on the dementia prevalence data here in the United States with Chinese American elders. And that's why we're showing you this table today. But just a cautionary note is that, you know, we just can't assume that prevalence rates reported in the Asian countries are the same as the ones as here in the US. So if you look at this table more closer, you'll see that the review of literature, that the range of the findings for all the prevalence, dementia prevalence rates is very extreme in both between countries, like between Hong Kong and Singapore. You'll see that the rates are drastically different. And even within the same country, like Japan, you'll see they also reported a wide range just with the percentage of the prevalence rate of people with dementia. And this pie chart shows an example of 126 Chinese elders who were evaluated for their cognition in a Chinese outreach clinic in the San Francisco Chinatown area. And while it doesn't represent the whole Chinese American population, this is one of the very few studies that shed some light on the presentation of the various types of dementia that we see in the Chinese elderly population. You'll see that 38% of these Chinese elders have either has an Alzheimer's disease alone diagnosis, or an Alzheimer's disease diagnosis with some kind of vascular brain damage associated with it. And another 38% has been diagnosed with mild cognitive impairment. And the smaller percentages of them were found with dementia with Lewy bodies, frontotemporal dementia, and progressive supranuclear palsy. An interesting finding is that what the researchers did in this study was that they also found that vascular disease alone and depression alone were both chief causes of cognitive complaints among these Chinese American elders. And similarly, to having no reported data on the dementia prevalence in Chinese American elders, there are also no data on the risk factors for this population, unfortunately. So nearly all of the studies that looked at the risk factors were done in Asian countries, primarily China, Hong Kong, and Taiwan. And here, and nearly all of those studies confirm that the increasing age is the most common, consistent, and consistent risk factor for dementia, and that women are marginally more likely to develop dementia and Alzheimer's disease, particularly in the very old age women. And it's on the basis that they usually have a longer life expectancy. And whereas with vascular dementia, they are slightly more prevalent in men in these Asian countries. And the SORL1 gene, which is thought to be an important gene to modify late onset Alzheimer's, was found in a few studies with Han Chinese people, but more studies need to be done in this area. And also, there are a number of evidence that shows that stroke injury and vascular factors increase risk for Alzheimer's disease and other dementias. So factors that decrease vascular function, like tobacco use, which is very common in China, it might further influence cognition in old age. And finally, a few studies done in China suggest that regular tea drinking may serve as a protective factor against Alzheimer's and dementia. But these studies have all relied on self-reports, so we need to interpret their findings more cautiously. So with this, I'm going to conclude my segment on a brief history of the Chinese American elders and an overview of the dementia prevalence rate and risk factors found in this population. And in this next segment, we will be hearing from Mr. Benjamin Gao on the cultural values of Chinese people and their perceptions of dementia and how it affects your work with these patients and their families.